Hi, today we'll discuss about self-management. Third talk on building emotional intelligence skills program. In yesterday's session, we had discussed about what self-awareness is, why we need to be aware of ourselves, and how is it going to help us in the long run. So in today's talk, we'll focus on self-management. So as we see, we have two words here. One is self, dealing probably with our emotions or how we react in different situations. And the second thing is management. Okay, so the word management suggests how you're going to handle yourself, how you're going to manage yourself. Now, before getting into the session, let us first discuss whether it is really important for us to manage our skills. Do we need to acquire this? Do we need to learn how to manage our skills? The answer is definitely yes. So if you want to progress, if you want to be successful in your life, definitely you need to learn how to manage yourself. So when you manage yourself, probably you are composing yourself, you are preparing yourself to meet any situation, any adverse situations, because as you know, things may not always go in the direction which we think. Sometimes things may go out of our hands. So in such situations, we should have the right skill set to manage our skills or manage ourselves so that we are not disturbed by the environmental factors. You might have heard about a very famous strategy, or you call it as marketing technique. So they you call it as a soft or SWOT, SWOT. So mostly marketing people will use this a lot. Now, what I firmly believe is this technique can be effectively used to manage our skill sets also. Now, when we look at SWOT, so we have strengths, means what we are really good at. We have weaknesses, something which you're not good at. Then the third one, O, represents opportunities. What are our opportunities? And T represents threats. Now, no pains, no gains, as simple as that. Unless until you don't take any pain, there's no way that you are going to get any gain out of it. So this SWOT can be a very useful technique to evaluate your basic personality traits. Like yesterday also, we have discussed about our strengths and weaknesses. So not only your strengths, it is also important for us to work with your weaknesses. See, there is no one perfect in this whole world. Everyone will have his own strength and weaknesses. The day you turn your weakness into strength, then you will be the most successful person in the world. Now, not only that, so when you have an opportunity, you also need to assess the threats related to it. Are there any hurdles to overcome? So when you not only estimate or take care to take over those hurdles or threats, then it paves way to have success. So you'll be able to conquer, or you'll be able to reap good results out of those opportunities. So I definitely understand saying is easy, putting things into practice is a little difficult. So when we talk about self-management, there are few things that we need to keep in mind when it comes to professional grounds. First one is time management. If you have given a commitment, always ensure that you are on time, or you may be 2 or 3 minutes or 5 minutes before, but not late. So time management is a very crucial factor that shows that you know how best you can manage your resources. Okay, so time management is the other important aspect that you need to keep in mind. Then stay calm. You need to manage your emotions. Sometimes things may not come in as we expected. So sometimes things may go out of our hands. That doesn't mean like we have to outburst or we have to shout at the other person. So you need to learn, we need to master the skill of having patience. Patience plays a major role. Don't suddenly outburst. So especially someone who are at manager level, management level. So you need to have this element of patience. We need to get the things done. That's what your job is. That's understood. But it really doesn't mean like you take the other person to the extreme level and where he resists, where he drops his weapons, or where he says, this is not my cup of tea, I'm not going to do this. So please don't take things to that extreme level. So have some patience, give some time to the other person, listen to the other person, what is he trying to say. So try to cultivate the habit of being calm and composed in every situations. So one of the prime qualities of a good leader is, however pressure he has within, he will not express that pressure on his face. See, just imagine as a team leader, if a team leader is nervous, then think about his team. His team will be more nervous. So it is not a point of getting nervous. You have to be more confident. You are, as a team leader, you are the hero of your team. So here, hero never is vexed, here hero is never nervous. You are the strength of your team. So stay calm, stay composed. If any one of your team members say that situation is not good, we will not be able to handle it. So give them courage, give them, motivate them. So when you are self-motivated, when you motivate yourself, then you will definitely have the courage to motivate others. See, Rome was not built in one day. It has taken many centuries, many years to build. Same is the case. Tell them like, however the situations turn out, you are always there to support them. You stand as a backbone to them, whether it is a good scenario or a bad scenario. So there are some leaders who even say that as a team, if we succeed, that is, the credit will be yours. And unfortunately, if we fail, I take the responsibility. It is the failure of the leader, not the failure of the team. See, the element of leadership skills, in element of courage, it's not that easy to take the blame of the team on the shoulders of team leader. In the first case, such a situation should not happen. But unfortunately, if it happens, so very few leaders will have the courage to say that if my team fails, it is my mistake. If they succeed, it is their success. So that is a prime quality of a good leader. So only a person who is calm, a person who is self-motivated can do this. Another aspect of managing or self-management is empathy. So yesterday also we came across this word empathy. So what does it mean? Empathy means looking at the things from the other person's perspectives. Means if something had gone wrong, instead of finding fault with the other person, okay, take time to step in the other person's situation. Look at the things from his perspective. So, empathy is a very good element, and a good leader, if you want to be successful, definitely you need to have empathy. So when you have empathy, when you look at things with an in an empathetic way, so most probably people will start liking you. So why would people like you? Because you are different from others. You are not the one who always finds a fault, or you are not one who blames, who throws the blame on others' shoulders. You are the one who are responsible. So when you are using empathy, you understand the situations in a better way. And understanding the situation in a better way can definitely help out to resolve the situations. See, there are many people who talk about problems, but very few talk about solutions. We don't want people who talk about more problems. Probably, definitely, we need more people who give good solutions. So, use your knowledge, use your wisdom. Think twice before you talk. And the main here another main thing is sometimes we get too carried out with work and we give a lot of commitment. So doing work is good. That should be highly appreciated. Okay, I'll not say anything about that. But taking to the extreme levels is also not good. Okay, so everyone has got his capacity. So what I'm trying to say is, please don't go beyond your capacity. So there's a big blunder. Often we do it. We give a lot of commitments without giving a second thought. Will I be able to fulfill all these commitments in the stipulated time? If you are able to do, that's excellent. That is highly appreciable. But let us take the other scenario where you're not able to do it. You're not able to complete it in the given time frame. Though you have given the commitment there is a risk that you will be at defame. So learning the art of saying no is also important. So I'm not asking you to say bluntly no. So no can also be said in a very polite way. So if you say no to the people on face, they will get offended. But if you put it in a way like this, I would have definitely done it, but unfortunately I would have to attend this work. But definitely if I complete the work as earliest as possible, it will be my pleasure to do it. So here we have two scenarios. The first scenario, when you said no, the person would have felt offended. But in the second scenario, you gave a reason. It is my pleasure, I would have definitely helped you out. But see, my situation is sore. I'm not in a situation to help you out. I'm already dealing with the thing. If I complete this thing, then definitely I will make it time to help you out. So this, what happens is, it makes the other person understand your situation and will not spoil the relations. Okay, and too much of work may exhaust us. If you are continuously working hours together, then our energy levels may be down. So don't get exhausted. Be energetic. Okay, take good food, good exercise. Take rest. Once in a while, a vacation is a good thing. Whenever you feel like you're burnt out, you're completely exhausted, it's not a bad idea to take a little relief. This will re-energize you. You will gain more energy. Sometimes it helps out with better ideas. So we'll be able to focus in a better way than before. So these are a few things that you can do at your workplace or to manage yourselves. To sum up, so what did we discuss in today's session? First thing is, stay calm. Okay, don't panic. Listen to the other person. Second, cultivate the habit of patience. Okay, have patience. Third, be confident. Whenever you speak confidently. Fourth, don't unnecessarily step in everything. Okay, so take up the things which you can confidently handle. Okay, and put as your heart and soul in whatever work you do. Give people the assurance that if some work is assigned to this person, definitely this person will give high productive, high quality work. So that should be the confidence which people should have on you. Okay, and don't take up too much of work. Okay, learn the art of saying no. Right, so don't burden yourself with a lot of work, and take care of your health. Health is wealth. If your health is not up to the mark, there's nothing much you can do. So health is also important. Okay, so and main thing is when we say self-management, we also talk about having a very delicate balance between the family and profession. So these two are two different and essential areas. Profession is also important, at the same time family is also important. You need to draw a line where your professional life should not superimpose your family, and your family life should not impose your professional life. So if you're handling a delicate balance between these two, then definitely you will evolve as a very good professional. Hope today's session was helpful. Okay, so once again, thank you for the session. Have a good day.